Hi, John here. I'm in Taihape at the moment, and I'm just heading back to Taupo that way, Napier's that way. There's the sign there, there's the sign Taupo, and there's the vehicle I've just bought for Maurice Baker, or for Marianne. It's nice to drive, beautiful. And I've gone down to Fielding to get it. I got off the mana bus at Palmerston North, and the guy picked me up and then came and I took off. I'm just on my way back. So I'm just going to have lunch. I'll just show you my lunch. Or breakfast, rather. Breakfast. This looks like this. I got some chicken. I got some bacon egg burger. Chicken. Yummy. Half a chicken. Yeah. I don't think I'll eat it all, but I'll certainly have some lunch. A bacon burger from Newell. Then, I got me some cake and some hot cross buns. The hot cross buns are fine. Hot cross buns, see? Hot cross buns. Cake. Cake and tea. Tea. So there, that's my breakfast. For growing boys. And my drink from on the road. And it says sugar free. Well, I don't know about that. I think it's what it's doing. But at least I'm not back. That's my lunch, or my breakfast rather. About 10 o'clock tonight. So I've got some bacon burger from just fresh from New World in Taihape. That's $1.99, and this was $5 or $6 or something for the stuffed chicken, and this one. That? They're hot. Feel it. There, it's hot. Okay, feel it. And some cheese. And cake. Cake is $1.99. Maybe a bargain. That's $4.99. Okay, so there, that's my breakfast. So I shall sit down and eat, but I'll put this somewhere where I can talk to you. Across there. Over there. And I'll talk over here. I'll put it on top of the cake. Because I won't be eating the cake. I'll eat the cake along the road. I'll put that there. So I can talk to you while I'm eating my breakfast. Okay, so I've come down on the mana bus. I had a nice trip. I was at the front at the top, right at the top end. Somebody got off in Rotorua. When they got off, I jumped in the seat. So, as it stands, I'll put this up the other way. Easier. I'm enjoying my trip back. I'm going to go into Putaruru and then up to Arapuni, go across to Arapuni, to Saishasuru, I'll put this under the camera to raise it up a bit so I can talk to you. That's better. There. Okay. Don't fall over. I'll put up a bit more over there. I won't fall off the edge. Right, it's just starting to rain a little bit. It doesn't rain too hard while I'm having breakfast. Okay, so today's Waitangi Day. It's the 6th of February 2018. and just, it's hot. I could have stopped at a truck stop where they had breakfast, but I thought no, better than get a fresh chicken. Yeah, buns are still hot, no? Very nice. Cheers. Morris, Mr. Morris, I'm enjoying myself with the bun. The rubbish up. What's the fun? Burger? From New World. Quick. From the bakery. I can't eat it all, but I'll eat it on the way home. I gotta get some Kentucky Fried Chicken. Tomorrow. On the way out. In Fung Rai. Maybe. Got my other pants. We're doing some great projects up there. Mr. Mark. Got him a nice wagon, beautiful wagon. Drive like a dream. Looks like the engine had a bit of work on it. Put the rubbish away. Take your rubbish. So we got fried chicken, beautiful. She cut some off for me. She knew I couldn't use a whole chicken. Anyway. Enjoy my trip. We're going to be doing some project at Morris. We've got 80 acres, so I've got to make sure a lot of things can happen on 80 acres. I've got some plans for big Polycom buildings, and they can be built on site. Concrete. Precast. And build up higher or add on. Beautiful, that's it, man. That's what I like about it. Fresh. And soft. Very soft. And man, I got no spoon. Stuffing. I love the stuffing. Oopsie. See how it just falls off? Eh? It falls off. Yeah. To my friends in California. So, anyway. And we go to town. Now, I'd like to bring you to New Zealand and enjoy a trip out with me. Just stuffing. Just melts. Hot cross bun. Hot. Cross. The only thing they didn't have was mussels. Love mussels. Good chicken, soft. Can't eat all that. This beef, Kentucky fries, and the burger, bacon, egg burger. Very. It is soft. Now, today is Waitangi Day. I got a message for all those people at Waitangi. We're going into a new phase. Or a new world order. I've prepared for that. While everybody's in the sleep. I've planned for it. Because it's vicious. Snake. It's killing. We don't know what to do. On the land. Oh man, this is just divine. Hot cross buns, huh? They were hot. That was hot. Fish. Chicken hot. And at the moment, I'm hot. It's just cooled down a bit. It's had a rain. I'm glad it's not raining while I'm having breakfast. Because I've got a long trip ahead of me. I left Kawakau and Pahia Bay Islands up that way. At 12:30 yesterday, I got here at 5:30 this morning to Fielders or Palmerston North. The guy had to come and pick me up on his truck. Jeff got a good bite. And I'm a McKinnon. Check it out. Man, this is beautiful. New World. Simply the best. Simply the best. Oh my hot dog buns. I haven't got time to cook. No. It just melts in your mouth. The worst thing is a chicken that you have to get a jackhammer. The black into it. On the Munnabus last night, it was calm all night, no wind, because the worst thing is a blowing wind on the Munnabus. It sways, the two-story one. It sways. And when it hits the bump in the road, they put the brakes on. We're in for a good year, Mr. Morris. I'm just telling you how to eat. Be looking at this. Half left and I can't eat it. You're struggling to get through the bacon. Beautiful. That does hot cross buttons. Oh! The cake for later. I just saw old Austin station wagon. Go past. Oh. couple of. You're set. With the hinge, I used to spray my face along the road. It refreshes me, my face, having water spray. You spray your face like that. Keeps away too. Here we go. That's breakfast. That was yummy. I think I'll have another bun on the way. So I'll just have a little talk shortly. I'll get this packed away. Get it in there. That's for later. Tomorrow I'm going to have a long drive, like old age. Oh, I didn't need that one. Well, the rubbish in there. Rubbish. Always clean rubbish when you clean it. Rubbish, that's rubbish. That's good. I think Mark has got a good vibe, that's huh? Just need a little tidy up. Be right. That's basically us. Okay, I'm going to have some talk. I'll stay over there. In the rough. So, get away. Along the road. And that's going to go in another bag. Here of New World. Thank you, New World. It was very nice. That's this. Left side. So, now I can have a talk. With Waitangi, I was going on about Waitangi. It's like this. The government and Jacinda Ardern make a deal with Maori and with the Ratna Church and the Whakamininga. I hear the Whakamininga pulled out away from them because I tell you what, it's a tax situation for the government and their ongoing legacy of fraud and corruption of the Maori land titles in this country. Now, we have the 1834 Declaration of War flag, or in other words, a state of emergency flag, for situations of war itself or financial investment banking interests threatened, which is the case of New Zealand, threatening the people of New Zealand by private corporations operating the government in Wellington separate from everyone else. The Iwi Māori Crown is a corporation, a private company, owned by the Queen and the New South Wales government and New Zealand government. It has nothing to do with anybody. And so, I am acting as surrogate king, emperor. The three kings emperors. King William III, the creator of the Bank of England and the pound note and the municipalities, 8-point star of St. Patrick's Church Order to collect the ground rent for leases on these lands and around the world of conquered lands by the King Emperor, all consolidated the inheritance, wealth and fortunes, prized possessions, seized properties and lands and countries into the King's Emperor's title. Now the last king on this planet Earth to have the jurisdiction of authority and admiralty of the sea and this 8-point star is King William IV. He gave the 8-point star flag for the four corners of this Earth planet under admiralty court martial law against any third party pirate like the government of New Zealand, New South Wales. They are third party to a two party contract between the parent and chief, three of them. Tira Waikato, Parehiri Hiri Manakau, of Maungatauteri Mountain. I'm going there today in Pohara Pa and Pohara Marae, right at the bottom base rock, face big rock. I'm going to film it. Of Te Rawakato Wharehere Manukau, Moriori tribe. So that's the title to this whole country that I'm filming today on the 6th of February 2018, Waitangi Day, as a commemoration to Te Rawakato Wharehere Manukau on my trip through today from Palmerston North back to Auckland and up to Hokianga. The other end of the chief there, the paramount chief, Huri Te Kuri. Now, the third paramount chief was Rewherewha Manukau. He made a contract with King William IV and this 8-point star on the flag, the declaration of war flag on anyone who gets in the road. Unfortunately for the government of New Zealand, they have gotten my road. And the police and the courts have committed treason against the King's Bench Court and me, the surrogate king, locked me up in prison, unlawfully, illegally, and effect of treason. So I'm going to start issuing a writ warrant of control and possession on each and every single person in this country who is a third party and cannot show me a title how they got there in the first place. So that's what I'm saying to those people, the iwi Maori trustees. Your day is over as far as fraud is concerned with your land titles, because none of you have refuted or rebutted the titles I have with the King George IV and Te Rawakato Wharehere Manukau, 1823 contract, private contract of Admiralty. That's the wealth that was created in this country, the title to this country is Te Rawakato Wharehere Manukau. So, on this Waitangi Day, that was the Queen's contract. I'm talking about the King's contract on this side, but that flag is nothing to do with Maori, it's nothing to do with the Crown, New Zealand, and New South Wales. It's all to do with the King who gave that flag. Not for Maori, because there was no Maori around in 1834, but gave it to the Paramount Chiefs. And there's no one talking Paramount Chiefs at all, because Paramount Chiefs are commercial contract landowners. commercial land owners. That means they are the wealth side of titles to this country and any country in the world, of a blueprint of Te Rawaikato Wharehere in the title, and the 1862 Native Land Act of New Zealand, which has Rogan and Rewharewha Manukau's name on it, as sold one piece of land of Pukekohe to King William IV through Rogan. That's the title I'm using as well, against the government of New Zealand. And we are Māori Crown Federal State Government of the world. We are Māori Crown King William IV Trust creditor, bank creditor over the New Zealand government. And today, I make this announcement on this video that we will bill the government of New Zealand 970 million trillion trillion pound note against John Key and Helen Clark, and also Queen Elizabeth II and Queen Victoria and all that followed in the Rothschild banks, money scam and fraud of titles in this country. So that's all I want to say today. I'm going to get on my way and make do with a good trip now that I have breakfast. So, make my way back. So with that, I'd like to say, have a nice day today. Stopping in Pohara Marae, in Arapuni, in the vicinity of Cambridge, and south of that to Kihikihi and Karapiro. Those three places and Arapuni go together with this Te Rawaikato Wharehere in Manukau, title to New Zealand. Has anybody got any title to put up against that? I'm citing you on this video today, 6th of February 2018, that the titles to New Zealand are under Te Rawaikato Wharehere in Manukau and King George IV in Edinburgh Magistrate Court, Richmond. And St. Mary's Church in Edinburgh, the birth, death and marriage certificates in 1823 at Rangitukia. Okay? Baker is a magistrate, resident magistrate in the office of the schoolhouse, still there in Rangitukia, on my land box. I can say it's my land box, others can say it's their land box, but I'm saying it's my land box. The Haho land box, the Rangitukia schoolhouse, and the Waiapu boundary area of Potikirua ki Waiapu boundary area of Uetaha, paramount chief. Okay, so it's quite a bit in it. It's all online, and my notary lawyer, Tony Fortune, is poring over the documents all for apostille and to seal so that I can use those documents legally as a Māori federal state government of New Zealand, Pacific Islands and the Commonwealth countries of the world in 250 countries with that rank. The 1834 declaration of a state of emergency flag. We're putting this country in a state of emergency of financial bankruptcy, with the government just announcing they're borrowing $1 trillion, and that's what I'm talking about. That's their bill, not ours. Okay, we've got a trillion pound note on each one's head with a birth certificate. My birth certificate is valued at $1 trillion. That's what I say, the King's surrogate. I am the surrogate for King William III King William the Fourth and King George the Fourth. And I'm a surrogate for the Paramount Chiefs, Te Rewakato Wharehere Here in Manukau of Cambridge, Waikato region, Rewharehere for Manukau, surrogate of Manukau Marae in Waiuku, south of Manukau Heads, and north head of Manukau Harbour at Pūpanga Manukau Marae there at Cornwallis. And a surrogate for Hori Tikuri of Taheke Marae, Native Magistrate Court. Te Unga Waka Native Magistrate Court is in Auckland, in Epsom, and that's our base for Marae's as Magistrate Courts, with what I'm just saying to you, sworn, apostolate, legal, legitimate, authentic documents of title. Okay, so those will go in a higher authority of British Empire and British Emperors, those three kings, Emperors. In particular, the 8-point star of King William III, the creator of this municipalities in Belfast, Northern Ireland, my family there, the Rogans, the Cosgroves and the Patricks. Coat of arms of Cosgrove and Cosgrove and Rogan. And the 8-point star here I'm wearing. The 8-point star, the authority for me to wear it for St. Patrick himself and his church in Belfast, that's my family. And for King William III, his wealth, inheritance, fortunes of Dutch origins, Caribbean, 300 million tons of gold, bullion, buried as dust, and Philippines, 1.5 billion, 5 million tons, bits of tons of gold, there. And the rest, scattered around, Switzerland, all of that is accounted for inside the 970 million trillion single pound note, a Maui pound note. Maui being the memorial to the world, planet, God's truth, deeds, truth, deed, title to this planet with the triangle I have in the circle of light, perfect triangle, square, mirror image, in a circle with the 3 points, East Cape, Ghana, and Rapa Nui, East Island, Top Midday, East Cape, Te Pito on my land block, 6 a.m., 6 p.m. on the beach in Accra, Phoenix Hotel. Those are the 3 points, the only 3 points in the world that are sun is shining on the sand. So that's all. It's windy now, and it'll affect the sound on this video, but hey, I'm having a nice day with no rain while I'm here talking to you. And so, we'll, for the last time, I'm citing this video, YouTube, as fact-cited evidence in our case against New Zealand government, the US federal state government, the British government, the Rothschilds, the United Nations, the EU Parliament, NATO, ISIS, Israel, Church and State, Church of England, Catholic Church. All those churches are evil. The people that are running it, the Pope, is the most evil man on this planet. Bergoglio, Jorge Bergoglio, the Argentinian murderer, is running the Vatican. Okay? So those are the people you're up against with the 970 million trillion pounds on your heads. All the states, all the Iwi Maori here is in it. they are stuck in that contract with Queen Victoria Cuddles that was stolen from King William IV and King George IV and King George V. They were stolen. Everything that the Queen touches is corrupted and fraud by the Rothschild banks. We're going to bankrupt everybody that's on that side because the flag we have is for that reason. It's still alive. Britain hasn't taken it away. We're going with Brexit. We're going to dump all the other politicians out of there and save all the money on their retirement fund and their pension and give it to the people that really need it. Okay, so that's all. We're going to be on our way now and we'll spot you later. Have a nice day. Goodbye. There you go. See ya. That's this place here, Taihape. Goes that way to Wellington, and that way to Taupo, and that way to Napier. So there we go. Okay, see ya. Bye.